Hello friend, now we are going to start the one of the tissue or one of the another tissue, permanent tissue. In previous class we have already discussed about meristematic tissue. So there is the characteristic features of meristematic tissue having the continuous division or growth and multiply the number of the cells. So but in permanent tissue, so there is no division takes place. So cells cease to divide and tissue, group of cells cease to divide and become permanent tissue. So permanent tissue is two types, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissues is common origin plus common function and common structure. So it's a homogeneous nature of tissues, homogeneous tissue, but complex tissue is heterogeneous tissue. So what having the common origin, common function, but different structure. So in complex tissue there are two types of tissues. First is xylem and phloem. So it will be discussed in the next classes. So a separate topic about the xylem and xylem cells and phloem and phloem cells. So we will discuss in next. So it's a separate topic will be there. So now come to the simple permanent tissue. So there are three types of simple permanent tissue. First is parenchyma. Second one, colenchyma. Third one is escalerenchyma. So these are the types of simple permanent tissue. So now we look how the meristematic cells turn into the permanent tissue, and then what the changes takes place in the simple permanent tissue to become the different types of tissues like parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. So first week here is the meristematic tissue. You see the meristematic tissue. So meristematic tissue should always divide, having the tendency to divide. Continuous cell division takes place and cells divide to produce 2, 4, 8 and more cells. So multiplication start always takes place in but there is no cell division, it become the permanent, cease to divide, and permanent tissue, this is the permanent tissue. So permanent tissue having three type: parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. So first the parenchyma. So parenchyma is nothing, it is just a first permanent, simple permanent tissue having thin wall. So thin walls and living cells, thin wall and living cells. So now there is no any cell division takes place in these tissues. So only the changes in its structure. So in parenchyma there is some chemical structure changes, that is called pactification. So pactification turned in parenchyma, so it produced to the another type of cell is called colenchyma. So pactification is nothing, it is just a chemical division over the surface or over the cell wall of parenchyma, it become the colenchyma. So depository nature. So it deposited nature, it is not a hard layer form. So it is a pervious layer. So pectin is nothing, it is just a pervious layer which allow water into the cytoplasm from outside. So this is the living cells or living tissues are having the deposition takes place. So it's having both function, both vital as well as mechanical function. So this is the function. Now another changes in the cells of this tissue, there is the heavy depletion of the chemical. That chemical is called lignin. So lignin is the hard chemical layer which doesn't allow water into the cell cytoplasm, and ultimately the cells become dead. So it's form the impervious layer, and impervious layer makes the cell dead. So now that there is the turning to the another type of the tissue, forming the tissue cells called sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma, this is the sclerenchyma colon. So this is the sclerenchyma. So in simple tissue there are three tissues: parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. So let's the characteristic features of parenchyma. What is parenchyma? So parenchyma is nothing, it is just a plastic tissue. Plastic tissue, it either change to the meristematic stage or meristem. It can either or change into another colenchyma and sclerenchyma, so having the tendencies to reverse back and goes forward. So this is the plastic in nature. Second one is thin wall cells. So parenchyma always thin wall. Thin walls. So thin wall is only primary wall. So primary wall is composed of cellulose only. So cellulose is thin layer. So all they are living cells. Or iska then the main function is storage. Function is storage. Storage. Function is storage. So this is all about related to the parenchyma. So this is storage. Whatever the storage function is occurs in parenchyma. So in the cortex region of the plant, parenchyma cells are present. Mainly hypodermis also. So in hypodermis, both parenchyma, colenchyma is present. Another specialization of parenchyma. This is the modifications. This is the modification of what? So parenchyma are three types. First is prosenchyma, arenchyma, and chlorenchyma. So parenchyma, prosenchyma, it is just a specialized change in the structure of the parenchyma. So here is the structure become the elongated to form fusiform structure. So this is the mainly form of the prosenchyma. So this is the another parenchyma is arenchyma. So mainly arenchyma present in the watery plant. Watery means watery plants, mainly watery plant it present. So they are having the in arenchyma cells are loosely connected to one another and form a gap or cavity. So this cavity is called so help in the buoyancy and filled with the air. So it becomes the arenchyma. So there are two type of cavity. So first cavity which is formed by the separation of the few cells on particular area. So that cavity is called schizocyrus cavity, and the another cavity formed by the breaking of the few cells and form a space or cavity. That cavity is called lysozenus. So there is schizocyrus and lysozenus. So this cavity, so schizocyrus cavity and lysozenus. So you know, and so this is all. Another form of parenchyma, modified parenchyma, is chlorenchyma. It present in the mesophyll cells. Mesophyll cells of leaf. So this is a more division of the chloroplast. So in this chlorenchyma cells, so more division of the chloroplast. So more chloroplast means help in the photosynthesis process, because it contains chlorophyll pigment, and chlorophyll pigment help in the photosynthesis, and which reduce the CO2, to produce more carbohydrate. So this is the modification for chlorenchyma. So this is all about related to the parenchyma. Another colenchyma is the colenchyma. So this is both vital as well as mechanical function. So it formed by the deposition. Deposition. So deposition. The prism may be angular, rectangular, lacunate type. So there are various specialization of angular collenchyma, lacunate collenchyma, and rectangular collenchyma. So it's related to the how the deposit is. So in angular type, so there is no gap present. So this is the collenchyma. So function is both vital as well as mechanical. So it is a pervious layer. It mainly present in the hypodermis region of the plant. Another collenchyma is sclerenchyma. So sclerenchyma is only function is only mechanical function. They are dead cell. All are dead cells. Why dead cell? Because the deposition of lignin, deposition of this is of lignin, and so it mainly present in the sclerenchyma. So sclerenchyma cells and become dead. So there is further divided into two types. One is sclerites, or another is fovea. It's a hard cells. It become the sclerenchyma become the hard cells. So it's also called stone cells. And the other is highly elastic in nature, and more fiber is present. So this is fiber. So there is further differentiate into two types: sclerite as well as fiber. So this is all about related to the simple permanent tissue. So simple permanent tissue of teeth type. So this is the next we come to the how the questions you can choose and you can process or you can find. So first you, what is parenchyma, where it present, what type of the cells, which type of layer, either thin layer or thick layer, it would be are the questions. If thin layer is present, so which chemicals are present there in parenchyma. So example of parenchyma. So another question would be asked in competitive examination like NEET or AIIMS. It's a modification of specialization of parenchyma. What is prosenchyma? So what is the main function? What is parenchyma? What is schizogenous cavity? What is lysosomal? How it form? So when the question would be there, so in parenchyma says a cavity formed by the separation of few cells toward the periphery of form a gap or cavity. That cavity is called lysogenous, first option. Second, lysosigenous, this is a schizogenous cavity. Third one, schizogenous cavity. Fourth, none of the above. So your answer is schizogenous separation. So another question would be, say cavity formed by the destruction of the few cells to form the gap or cavity. And so there are so many questions, options are there. It would be, or it will be lysogenous cavity. So here, another is the which type of the chlorenchyma present in question would be asked. Which type of chlorenchyma would be present in chlorophyll or mesophylls of leaf? So it would be, it will be chlorenchyma. So heavy division of the. Another, you can ask the questions, heavy division of the chloroplast in which chlorenchymal cells? So in which cells of parenchyma? In which specialized form of chlorenchyma? As I said, it would be the. So these are the corner section or finding corner. So you can process the questions, exercise, problem. So there are many. So what is the changes? So this is the, what is the, here the changes in the parenchyma to first is pectification, second one is lignification. So pectification form the a layer of pectin. In lignification, so lignin layer, so lignin layer become impervious, so there is no exchange of water takes place, so cells become dead. So lignification become the sclerenchyma and pectification is collenchyma. So this is all related to the collenchyma. So it is here, all about here. Okay, hope you understand well. and process the problem finding. Okay, thank you.